गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स. इन द लास्ट लेक्चर वी हैव सीन इम्पैक्ट ऑफ जेट ऑन मूविंग कर्व प्लेट व्हेन द जेट स्ट्राइक द प्लेट एट द सेंटर. ओके, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू सी द एग्जांपल ऑफ इम्पैक्ट ऑफ जेट ऑन अ मूविंग कर्व प्लेट व्हेन द जेट स्ट्राइक्स टेंजेंशियली एट वन टिप एंड लीव्स एट द अदर. ओके, दिस इज द एग्जाम्पल. Okay, where this is a pipe, this is a nozzle, and the water from the nozzle strikes the plate tangentially and it moves out and it comes out from the other tip. Now this is the inlet tip at which the jet enters the vane or the plate, and this is the outlet tip at which the jet exits the plate or vane. Okay. Now these are some abbreviations, V1, V2. Okay. Now V1, V2. V1 is the absolute velocity of the jet at the inlet tip, and V2 is the absolute velocity of jet at the outlet tip. Okay. The absolute velocity of the jet at inlet and outlet tip respectively. Now next is the U1, U2. Velocities of the plate at inlet and outlet respectively. What is U1 and U2? It is velocities of the plate at inlet and outlet respectively. Okay, so here U1 is the velocity of the plate at inlet, and here U2 is the velocity of the plate at outlet. Okay, next. VR1 and VR2. These are the relative velocities of the jet at inlet and outlet tip respectively. Okay. Now, this is VR1. Okay. This here, it is VR1. That is the relative velocity at inlet tip. And this is VR2. That is relative velocity at the outlet tip. Next. VF1 and VF2, velocities of the flow at inlet and outlet respectively. Okay, so this is VF1 or velocity of flow at inlet, and this is VF2, it is velocity of flow at outlet. Okay, and next is the VW1 and VW2, that is velocities of the whirl at inlet and outlet tip respectively. Okay, so we'll see. Okay. This is VW1, that is velocity of whirl at inlet, and this is VW2, velocity of whirl at outlet. Okay. Now all this VR, that is relative velocity, VF, that is velocity of flow, and VW, velocity of whirl at inlet and outlet. We'll study all these velocities in detail in this lecture. Okay. So moving forward, theta and phi. This is a phi. They are the tip angles at inlet and outlet respectively. Okay. So at inlet, theta is the angle made by relative velocity with the horizontal. Similarly, at the outlet, phi u is the angle made by relative velocity with the horizontal. See, theta is the relative velocity made by theta is the angle made by relative velocity with the horizontal, and phi is the angle made by the relative velocity with the horizontal at the outlet tip. Next, alpha and beta. These are the angles which the absolute velocities make at inlet and outlet respectively. We'll see alpha and beta. Okay, this is alpha. Alpha is nothing but the angle made by V1, that is absolute velocity at inlet with the horizontal, and beta at the outlet. This is the beta. It is the angle made by absolute velocity at the outlet with the horizontal. Okay. So now we'll briefly see and we'll discuss this case in detail. Okay. Now, the figure in the last slide shows a jet striking a moving curved plate at one tip and leaving at the other. That is this diagram. Okay? This is the jet striking tangentially at this is the jet striking tangentially at one tip and exiting at the other tip. Okay. Now the absolute velocity of the jet is V1, as we see here. Absolute velocity of the jet when it comes out of the nozzle, it is V1. But the movement of the plate is in the x direction with a velocity u1. We will see. Okay. Now, this is the plate. Now, it is moving in the x direction. Okay. Now, at the inlet, the velocity of this plate, it is given here, it is u1. Okay. Okay. But the movement of the plate is in the x direction with a velocity u1. Hence, the effective velocity with which the jet strikes the plate is the relative velocity vr1. Now, in the last cases, for example, impact of jet on moving flat plate and impact of jet on moving inclined plate, what we used to do was relative velocity was v minus u, where v was the velocity of jet and u was the velocity of the plate. But in those cases, v and u were acting in the same direction. That is, the direction of the velocity of jet was also x direction, and the direction of the movement of plate, okay, with velocity u, it was also the same x direction. So both the jet and the plate were moving in the same velocity. So our relative velocity was v minus u. Okay. But in this case, the absolute velocity v1, its direction is different, and velocity of the plate, okay, movement of the plate in x direction, its direction is different, u1. Okay. So the effective velocity with which the jet will strike the plate is vr1. Okay. The relative velocity vr1 may be obtained by drawing the velocity triangle at the inlet. We'll draw this velocity relative velocity triangle in the next slides. Okay. Just you have to, in this slide you have to remember absolute velocity of the jet is v1 and the velocity of the movement of plate is u1. So the effective velocity with which the jet will strike the plate, it will be relative velocity vr1. Okay, next impact. Next, now we'll see at the other tip, that is this, at the outlet tip. What will happen is, at the other tip, that is the outlet tip, the jet leaves the curved plate with a relative velocity vr2. Okay, now in the last slide we have seen that the effective velocity with which the jet strikes the plate is the relative velocity vr1. So if the jet strikes the plate with the relative velocity vr1, and if the plate is smooth and there is no loss of energy, then the jet will come out of the plate at the outlet with the relative velocity vr2. Okay. At the outlet tip, the jet leaves the curved plate with the relative velocity vr2. See, but what happens? But the movement of the plate is in the x direction with a velocity u2 at the outlet. Okay. The movement of the plate, okay, the movement of this plate is in the x direction, as we have seen earlier. And at the outlet tip, that velocity is u2. Okay. So u2 is the velocity of the plate in the x direction at the outlet. So hence, the absolute velocity v2 may be obtained by drawing the velocity triangle at the outlet. Okay, so we are going to draw a velocity triangle at the inlet, and next we are going to draw a velocity triangle at the outlet. Okay, now how to draw those velocity triangles, that we will continue in the next lecture. Okay, thank you.